السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. What is the meaning of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah? You became a Muslim, you said that you bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you bear witness that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger. Very briefly, the first part of what you said is that you bear witness as if you see it with your own eyes. You have the certainty, the belief that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha. La means no one. Ilaha in Arabic means the one to be worshipped. The one to be worshipped with perfect love and perfect submission. There is no one worthy of that except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth. That's why it's made of two parts. The first part, negation, negating everything that is being worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second part, affirmation, that He is the only one worthy of worship. La ilaha illallah. And we have to understand that this is the meaning of word ilah. Ilah is the ma'bud, is the one to be worshipped. And we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I said, with two pillars, very important, with the perfect love that is only between the slave and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you love anything on the face of earth, it's all creation of the creator of the heavens and the earth. They have deficiencies. And this is a basic characteristic to any of the creation of Allah. But when it comes to the Most High, the creator, the sustainer, the all-seer, the all-hearing, He is the most perfect subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He is the one to be loved, a perfect love. And that's why we worship Him. We say La ilaha illallah with the perfect love and the perfect submission. We submit to all the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because He's the most wise. We are pleased with Him as our Lord, and we are pleased with the religion of Islam, and we are pleased with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is the first word. La ilaha illallah, nothing or none is worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once the person believes in this and in his heart is firmly believing in this, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, the sustainer, then He is the only one to be worshipped, and that acts of worship are everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves for us, we get to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We get to know the creator of the heavens and the earth with His names and attributes. How can we worship Him? How can we make sure that we are pleasing Him? This is the second part of the shahada, and that is ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. If you get to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to know that the only way to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the first shahada is the kalimatu tawheed, the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one is the oneness of following all the different paths to salvation, all the different paths to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the paths to the Jannah, to the paradise, have been blocked once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent only his way. He's the first one to enter Jannah, and people behind him will enter. No one, if they come from different routes, they won't be able to enter the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till they follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is another tawheed. This is another oneness, but oneness in following the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he does not speak from his desire, he speaks from the revelation. وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. That he only speaks from the truth, he does not speak from his desire. So we have to understand this very well, and we have to make sure that we follow the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in all aspects of our life. And what negates أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, what negates this word is the innovation in the religion. What negates La ilaha illallah is shirk, associating partners with Allah. What negates the second word, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger, is the innovation in the religion. And that's why we need to do what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did in matters of the religion, and we do not do the things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't do in matters of the religion. Whether it's matters of belief, whether it's matters of ibadah, prayer, our dhikr, our remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything in our matters of the religion, we only do what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, which makes the life of the Muslim easy. Our job is to get to know the truth. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, what the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said and applied in the religion of Islam, this is what we need to have, this is what we need. Once we get to know it, we have nothing but to submit ourselves to the orders of Allah and the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So once a Muslim says, I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger, the whole entire life of a Muslim changes. Why does it change? Because everything has to fulfill what we said. We have to be truthful of what we say. So anything that we do it only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any deed to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have to come from these two words. Sincerity of intentions, we do things only for the pleasure of Allah, which is the meaning of La ilaha illallah. The hearts are pure, have ikhlas and pure, that it only seeks the pleasure of one and only one. And that is the creator of the heavens and the earth. And that's why any deed won't be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unless the person is sincerely doing it for the sake of Allah. The second condition is that this deed has to be according to the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the meaning of Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. I bear witness that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger. It's not just words, has no meaning to it. Has a meaning, it's a lifetime that the person has to make sure that whatever he's doing is according to the way of the Prophet ﷺ. And that's why based on La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, me and you, everyone, all Muslims, we need to ask ourselves two questions before we do any deeds. It is not just for the people of knowledge, every single man and woman as a Muslim, we need to ask ourselves before we do any deed. Why are we doing it and how are we doing it? If we have the answer of why we are doing it, we refer back to La ilaha illallah. We're doing it for the pleasure of Allah, because there is no one worthy of worship except the creator of the heavens and the earth, and that's why we're doing it. How are we doing this act? Is from Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. From that we bear witness that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the final messenger. So we do the acts of worship. How we do it? Following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, by making sure that we are doing things exactly the same way he did. He said, صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِي أُصَلِّي. He said, pray in the same manner that you saw me praying. He said, خُذُوا عَنِّي مَنَاسِكَكُمْ. Take from me the rituals of Hajj. That's how we make Hajj. That's how we make Salah. That's how we make Zakah. That's how we do everything in our life according to the perfect example. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved his seerah, his way and his life and his actions and his speeches for us to follow, as if he is living among us. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the true worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who understand the meaning of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, to live our life with sincerity and following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and never to negate it. Never to negate it by committing shirk, calling unto other than Allah, seeking istighatha and help and dua and things of that nature, any form of ibadah to other than Allah. This can take the person outside the fold of al-Islam, and at the same time never innovating in the religion of al-Islam, but nothing but being followers of the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us all steadfastness on the beautiful religion of al-Islam, and to keep us like that till the moment of death comes, fulfilling the orders of Allah, worshipping none but the creator of the heavens and the earth. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.